Anyone free to take a call to the station? Over.
Down here. I'll take it.
Okay, Leon. It's Hello. Mr. Lewis. Over.
Oh. Good evening. Right there, taxi. Mr. Lewis. Can you hold the line a moment, please?
Coffee. Sorry to keep you waiting. You want a taxi? I'm Deborah Nightclub on the left in the seafront. That's fine. 11:50? Okay.
Is anyone going to say anything? Blimey, we've just seen a ghost.
Ghosts don't peep through letterboxes. Anyway, I saw his face. It was a man.
Oh, come off it. But his dad said it was haunted.
That doesn't mean we saw the ghost. I think it was a man.
You said that, but he lived there.
Maybe he doesn't live there. Maybe he was just looking round.
Who was he then? Hey, maybe he's a murderer or a kidnapper.
Honestly, Jules, your imagination. It was probably a tramp looking for somewhere to stay the night.
Wasn't a tramp, was it, buddy? You saw his eyes, they were loony, weren't they?
I don't know.
Oh, blimey!
I swear I'm going to pull those phones off the line one of these days. You're laid back. What you all been doing, eh?
Oh, nothing. Is Dad out driving?
What do you think? He loved that car more than me. A too plump for him, eh, buddy?
Yeah. Honestly, I didn't think...
Oh my, out of the mouths of babes and sucklings come the truth. Now you hear those phones again, they're going to drive me mad.
Oh God.
No, you get me a cup of coffee and a couple of sweet biscuits. Then you two, straight to bed. Are you plump for my body?
I like your mum.
Yeah, she's all right. Except she makes us go to bed too early.
Yeah, my mum does too.
Oh, buddy.
Your place is nice. Neat and tidy. My house used to be like this when my mum was there. Now it's just a dump.
And what do you do about it?
Mum says we've got to go to bed. Right now.
I'm just going.
What are we
going
to do at the house?
What can we do? Anyway, it's just stupid.
Oh, come off it.
Buddy's right.
Blimey, first interesting thing that's happened in years, and you're just boring.
Well, suppose I'd better go to bed.
Yeah. See ya.
You're quite busy tonight, but I'll let you have one as soon as possible, okay? Right. Good night, buddy. You catching the bus?
No, I walk.
It's cold outside. You want me to call my husband? He can give you a lift.
No, it's okay. Does he work all night?
Oh, sometimes. We can't get drivers at all. So if you know of any, tell him about us, yes? What does your father do?
Oh, things, you know.
Your mum, she works too?
Yeah. Good night, Miss Ribeiro.
Good night, buddy. Hello? Ribeiro taxi?
Like father, like son.
Just make some tea. What do you think?
I think I want a cup of tea.
No, the cleaning. I've done all the rooms. Took all morning.
You must be thirsty then, so bring the tea. Char lady, you would. How much do you charge? Go on, how much?
Nothing.
Blimey. Don't ever do nothing for nothing, mate. Let's see. It's worth what? Tenner? Go on, they're yours. Plenty more where they came from. We'll go down to the shops later and buy you some trousers.
Where'd you get
them? Ask no questions and I'll tell you no lies. I'm working, right? Now shut your gob and drink your tea.
Rave on and tell me, not to be lonely, tell me, you love me only, rave on to me.
Buddy!
What?
Make sure you've got clean underpants on. Don't want you showing me up in the shops. My old mum used to say, Terry, always make sure your undies are clean. If you get run over, I don't want the doctors to think I'll let you run around dirty. Poor old dear Minnie and all. Bless her heart. Didn't know which flavour, so I bought the lot. There you go. Drink up.
It's beer.
Of course it is. It's a pub, innit? Want one of these? That's right, mate. You lay off them. 20 a day when I was your age. Now I can't stop. Patchy. Here it is, Dougie. Oi, Dougie! All right? Shadow's mad, he was. Always in the shop, looking for Shadow's records. Do you remember the shop?
Of course.
Best days those was. Broke my heart when it burnt down. Still got the report. Front page it was. That's me.
No.
Just think. All them old rebels up in smoke. Of course,
Old wooden top here didn't have it insured, did he? Your mother went mad when I told her. Blimey. Right, little boozer. Suppose you want another one? Mama. Oh. Bit boring, then, eh? What's that with a nice pair of drape bars like these in?
They're for school, Dad.
Oh, dear. My son's a right square. What else do you fancy? Shirts? Never know. Underpants? Might buy the old shop, mate. Thinking. If I can't get the money together, might buy another record shop. Be a bit of all right, wouldn't it?
Be great.
Get it insured this time and all. Need a lot of money, though.
Mrs. Ribeiro said they need taxi drivers.
Too young to drive.
Not me, you.
What, me? Work for Jungle Bunnies? Do us a favour.
They're not Jungle Bunnies.
Could have fooled me.
Anyway, it's not a point. It's a good job.
I've got a job, haven't I?
Yeah, but...
Yeah, but what? I don't get you. You moan when I ain't got no money. Then you moan when I make a bit. Got your trousers, didn't you?
I'm not moaning.
Barrel of laughs, you are. Got to go to work. I'll be late tonight, tomorrow and all. I'll be working nights a lot, okay? You'll be all right.
Oh, now, lad. That's a bit more like it.
Yes, sir.
That bag still makes you look like a dustman, though. Still, anything's better than nothing.
Dustman. He wears a dustman's hat, he wears gorblimey trousers, and he lives in a...
Just watch it, Siddle. Watch what, Clark?
They're so violent, aren't they?
Just watch it, right?
Oh,
Butcher?
Hello?
Fancy going to the flicks tonight?
Yeah.
I ain't working tonight. Let's have a cup of tea first and we'll go.
This morning.
Yeah, somebody rang up asking for a taxi to take them to the docks.
So?
So I asked them for the address where they wanted to be picked up. It was 56 Croxley Street.
It's true, I heard it.
I thought I was hearing things, so I asked the man to repeat it.
What did you do?
So I called a taxi in Delgado Street, so he went. And a bit later, he came back to the office, and I poked him all casual like.
You should have seen him. He thinks he's a real smoothie detective.
Yeah, last I found out loads. The bloke he picked up was short, fat, and big thick glasses and grey hair, and he was wearing a black coat. He had a suitcase and Del said he wore a ton. He went to the docks and got out of a pub. I told you there was something weird going on.
It's not that weird.
Of course it is. For a start, why is there a phone in an empty house that's all boarded up? Anyway, we'll soon find out.
How?
Because we're going there. Come on.
Now what? There's nothing to see.
I'm not going round the back.
Julius! Honestly, that kid. Come on, we can't let him go alone.
Someone burst caught Shah. I was just behind the edge when she came belting past. Then this lady opened a window.
In the house?
No, next door.
Did she tell you off?
She wants to tell me something.
You're not going?
She said it was important.
She's nuts.
What'd she want? She asked me if I like cats. Then she said she had something important to tell me.
Probably wants us to clear up some cats missing on the floor. Sounds as though she needs oiling.
I saw you round here the other night, didn't I? You could get yourselves hurt, you know. I was going to warn you, but I never open my door at night. Old ladies like me get mugged at night. Worse, sometimes. You'd laugh at the other side of your face if he caught you in his garden. It's nearly four. Time for his walk.
Who?
The beast. That's who. They ought to put him under lock and key before it's too late.
What does he do?
He strangles cats. He'd probably do the same for you, and good riddance. He killed my Katerina. Held up her poor little body to taunt me. I saw it from my window. I see everything from up there. He'd kill Ida too, given half a chance. But Mummy won't let him, will she, my lovely?
Strangling a cat? That's awful.
There. I knew you'd understand. This is Ida. Say hello to the nice young lady. And I'm Mrs. Solomon, in all her glory.
How do you do? My name's Charmian, and this is my brother...
Murderer! I know all about you, don't think I don't. Comings and goings in the middle of the night. You killed my Katerina. Beast! Now, don't you go hanging around here anymore, especially at night. It's not safe for a young girl like you.
Well, I think we'd better go now. Bye.
Come on, Shah!
hurry.
What do you think? We're going in there while he's out. Come on.
Buddy, don't!
Oh, well, here's a hand.
Take these. Got it?
The side door was open.
He must eat them cold.